Hello everyone and welcome to the Geek Show, and today we're here for a game of football, but not the football that the majority of people on the planet know and love. No, we're not talking about the one that Americans call soccer. We're talking about a different type of football, but it is still football technically. That means we're not talking about FIFA, we're not talking about PES, we're not talking about anything like that. See, loads of people love football, and there are certain communities that really like alpacas. And in something that seems like a prescient event, and I believe was in no way related to the game that we're talking about today, in Yorkshire, during September this year, an alpaca made a pitch invasion on a local game. You'll find videos of this on YouTube. This must have been some kind of serendipity for Salt Castle Studio, the developers of Alpaca Ball Allstars, which is available now on PC. Alpaca Ball Allstars has you taking on the role of an alpaca, and you play football to all intents and purposes. Now, anyone who's played Rocket League will be familiar with a different take on the whole football game. In fact, anyone who's played Mario Strikers Charge Football or FIFA Street or something like that will be familiar with alternative versions of football. And Alpaca Ball is probably the most bizarre version I've seen for a while. It's kind of Mario Strikers Charge Football, but with alpacas instead of Nintendo characters. And on the surface, that seems more than strange, but there is a lot of fun to be had if you're playing against other people. There are different match modes that you can have in this game. You can have 1v1, 2v2, 4v4, and you can have up to 8 players. There are also different types of balls that you can use, which really change up the gameplay. And the game is fairly simple to get to grips with. It's very, very straightforward. There's nothing really new that it's doing. I mean, the power-ups are suitably strange and bizarre. I mean, an armadillo on the pitch is something that I didn't expect to see. You can also bash your opponents and ram into them. You can dive kick the ball. You can do power shots. Various things like that. This is one of those games where it takes a little bit of skill and a lot of luck, because the physics engine on this is very, very chaotic. And it's often really difficult to tell where the ball is going to go. It has that degree of unpredictability with it, which can make it a lot of fun when you're doing local co-op or online co-op. But it kind of makes it a little bit dull when you're doing a single player campaign. And it does have a campaign mode on this. For want of a better term, it's a campaign mode. Story mode, let's call it that. Where you take on the role of a young alpaca who, his mountain is going to be taken over by a rich alpaca who's wearing a monocle. That's how you know he's rich. And he wants to develop the mountain into a resort, and your mother's going, oh no, they're going to take away our home. And you have to become a superstar alpaca ball player who has all of the money so you can save your home. And that's why you embark on your quest to play alpaca ball and take on all comers and conquer the world, or conquer the area that you live in. And there are various pitch types as well. You have volcanoes, you have grasslands, you have ruins, you have streets. The game itself is very, very colourful. The alpacas are suitably alpaca-ish, and the only thing that really changes from one alpaca to another is basically the skin. Sometimes the coloration, sometimes it's the hairstyle, sometimes it's whether they're wearing a monocle or not. They all move in a suitably cartoonish way, and in general, it's a very, very simple game. It's a very easy game to pick up and play, and that's its blessing and also its curse, because it does make it very, very repetitive in story mode, and it can get repetitive in co-op mode as well. It is the sort of game where you put it on for a short while and play it, but you wouldn't put it on for a long period of time. It's more of a game that you put on for shits and giggles, more than it is a game that you put on because you want to be a serious contender. And in that way, it differs from things like Rocket League, where people do take it seriously, and I'm still surprised by that. I wouldn't say it's a party game, but Alpaca Ball All-Stars does have an environment in which it would really shine, and that is the same kind of environment that games like Nidhogg really shine. See, Nidhogg is one of those games where gamers love to play it with other gamers, because it requires a degree of skill, but also has a degree of unpredictability to it. And so when gamers play other gamers, you can see who the best person is. And Alpaca Ball All-Stars is one of those games. Because of the chaotic physics engine, the skill part comes in actually maneuvering the ball into the goal in one way or another. But the unpredictability is with the ball type, the pitch type, and the way and whatever strange power-ups are being used at that particular time. That said, you don't have to be a gamer to really enjoy this game. I think this is the type of game that would really appeal to a younger audience as well. It has the cartoonish aspects of the alpacas, and the alpacas are suitably cute and fluffy and everything like that. So younger children, I think, as well, they would like the unpredictability of this game. They would like the fact that the alpacas run around on the pitch in goofy ways and they can become dizzy and they can slam into each other. And it becomes one of those games where you just put two kids with controllers in front of the PC and let them while away the time trying to play each other at Alpaca Ball All-Stars, and you can have a peaceful afternoon. Well, reasonably peaceful anyway. So that's Alpaca Ball All-Stars. It's not really a complex game. It's fairly straightforward. It wears its heart on its sleeve, and because of that, I kind of like it. But it also kind of annoys me at the same time. I think that because it's so simplistic and because it's so straightforward, I find I get bored of it quite easily, and I want something that I can actually sink my teeth into, something with more depth. But that's not to say there isn't an audience out there for this game. There very easily is an audience out there for this game. I think that I am on the margins of that audience, but I think there is a big audience out there for this game. And I think that if one of the bigger YouTubers or one of the bigger Twitch streamers picks up Alpaca Football and starts playing it and has a lot of fun with it, then this could be the next big thing. So, let us know what you think about Alpaca Ball All-Stars. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Are you indifferent to it? We're always interested in finding out what people think of the games that we review. If you liked this video, then give us a thumb, a sub, or a bell. And if you want to support us, then check out our Patreon. The details are in the description. If you're after more video game chit-chat, then you can subscribe and join us every Thursday for Impossible Mission. So that's it for now. I'll be back with another review very soon. Until then, thanks for watching.